below there. On the last tutorial, I have shown the basics for making simple materials using nodes inside the Cycles render engine. But those materials were, indeed, very simple, containing only diffuse color. So, do you want to know a simple way to create a lot of details on the diffuse material, using nodes inside the Cycles engine? Well, I have the right technique for you. So, I will assume that you already have a diffuse material node set up. All you have to do is add a bump node, a glossy node, and a mix shader node. The bump node will generate bump maps based on the brightness of the colors of your material. The glossy node will add more realistic reflections to your material. The mix shader serves the purpose of mixing the diffuse color and the bump node with the glossy node. The material output will look like a much more detailed and realistic version of the material. By making some slight alterations, it is possible to change the aspect of the material to make it look more like metal, rubber, wood, skin, or any other material you want it to be. My advice is to always save your most used materials on a file, so you can easily import them as needed. Well, looks like that's all for today. Subscribe for more animations, virtual reality content, Blender tutorials, and all sorts of conspiracy theories and weird videos.